Hello guys, what's up? I'm Brian here doing another video for you guys, and this time we recently had the Toy Fair and we had so many reveals, you'd think that we couldn't get any more. Oh, but we do. Toys R Us Canada has us covered because we've got some more listings. Now, some of this we actually covered previously in some rumors a while back, and it seems like these are pretty much confirming it. So let's go ahead and talk about the new ones. I'm not going to go over the same ones that we've already talked about, like the Quintesson Judge. I mean, we've known that for the Toy Fair. We've actually talked about that rumor as well previously. I'm just going to talk about the stuff that we have not seen and the new things that we could talk about. So, Generation Selects has a lot of new figures. Let's go over some of the ones that we already knew about. We knew about Hubcap, which we are going to guess is going to be a repaint of the Cliffjumper. I mean, that would make sense. And it'd be kind of funny considering that the original Titans Returns Bumblebee had a red repaint that was actually made into Chase. And so we're going the other way around. We're going to have Cliffjumper being made into yellow, but it's going to be made into Hubcap. I think that is a nice idea. We also have Rotorstorm, which we had mentioned before. Hot House, which we have mentioned before. Rotorstorm, I'm going to guess, is going to be a repaint of the Spinister, but we'll have to wait and see. Hot House, I think, might be a repaint of, let's say, maybe Airwave, just a guess. We also have a G2 Megatron in the Selects toy line, so this isn't going to be that regular release Earthrise figure, but it's probably going to be a repaint of that in green, which makes a lot of sense. Rorichi, which is apparently a redeco of Fast Track, we had mentioned that previously, but the new ones for Selects is Bug Bite. We didn't know about this, so this is brand new, and it is likely going to be a white repaint of the Cliffjumper, and we also have a Clones 2-pack, which is awesome, because we've had the clones before, but they were released irregularly. They had a very strange release, and it wasn't cool. We had the 2-pack that was a Walgreens set, and to get the rest of the clones, you had to get those big box sets that were like $150. It wasn't that cool. So now to have the 2-pack, I'm hoping that it's just the set of the same guys, and we don't have to pay Takara pricing or have all these exclusive box sets. Continuing on, we also have Deluxe Exhaust, which is likely going to be a repaint of Wheeljack, which sounds awesome. We also have Grease Pit, which I'm going to guess is going to be a repaint of the Ironworks figure that we already have, but it could very well be a new mold. I mean, it's in the basic Deluxe class lineup. It's not like the Selects where it's a repaint. We also have a Voyager Seeker 2-pack, which if I were to guess, maybe it's Sunstorm, or maybe it's Skywarp and Thundercracker in the Earthrise design. We also have the MicroMaster Spy Patrol, which people would assume is going to be the Selects line, but this seems to be in the Earthrise lineup, so maybe it's a different 4-pack than what we've already known. We'll just have to wait and see. And we also have Seeker Thrust, which is awesome. Now, that pretty much confirms that we're going to get the Coneheads. If you've seen the Skylinks packaging, it also shows Thrust, Ramjet, and Dirge. I'm not sure if the 2-pack will contain Ramjet and Dirge, but I guess we'll have to wait and see. I just feel like it's going to be Skywarp and Thundercracker, if anything. And then in Transformers Cyberverse, we have Repugnus's Revenge, which I'm going to assume is going to have a couple of repaints of the Repugnus figures. And we also have a Cyberverse Sinister Seeker Strike Force, which could be a couple of just Seeker repaints. We'll just have to wait and see. I'm not specific on who it's going to be. Maybe it's just generic characters. Last but not least, we have a movie masterpiece with an unknown name, so I can't really comment on that. And we also have, for other, an SDCC exclusive pack that combines G.I. Joe with Transformers. So that sounds interesting. Not much to say there, but it's cool. So with that, what do you guys think? Please comment below, let me know. Please like, comment, share, subscribe, and all those fun doodads. And I'll see you guys next time.